caught at the light out my window. I was shooting my shot, watching fireworks in the sky. In the summers, we let the top down, soak up the light. All I wanted was just to lock down the love of my life, nice and simple, like a midnight drive. Watching fireworks in the sky. I'm calling it now.
Thank you so much. So good to see all of you here tonight. Apologies, I'm trying to get organized here. So hi everyone, I'm Lisa Gold, A4's Executive Director. Quick accessibility check, I'm a Hapa, half Korean, half white woman with dark hair pulled up in a bun, wearing a purple printed top in a big open community room. And welcome everyone to September's Town Hall. We are celebrating the restart of New York's live cultural programming. And we're also celebrating the Mid-Autumn Festival and the Moon Festival and Mooncake Festival and Water and Moon Festival and Chuseok and the Children's Festival and Tsukimi. So all these great things. It's a big, huge full moon. So I'm so happy that you can all be here with us tonight to join us and learn about some of the incredible work that's being created in our city with a boost from arts recovery programs that are really making a big difference to artists and the arts sector after a really, really difficult past 18 months. And I know I personally am so excited to hear about all the different things that you all are bringing and launching and organizing and presenting with the support of the City Arts Corps program, the New York NYSCA's Restart New York Live Performance Grants, and all sorts of other things. So for those of you who are familiar with A4, you know that we're dedicated to ensuring greater representation, equity, and opportunities for Asian American artists and cultural organizations through resource sharing, promotion, and community building. And Town Hall is one of the signature programs that helps us fulfill that mission. So, I see so many familiar faces. It's really nice. I know I'm gonna like shout out every. I can't shout out everybody because I only have one screen and I have two screens of people here. But anyway, I know many of you have been to Town Hall before, but there are a few new faces to me anyway. So I'm just gonna share a couple of Zoom protocols before you start. Everybody is muted, and we ask that you stay muted unless you're speaking. We are recording this event. I believe we are recording this event. Yes, we are recording this event. And we will be posting it online on our YouTube channel for viewing later. You can note if you choose to ask a question or you want to say something, you can, there's a raise hand function that you can click on in the, I think it's under the participants icon, the bottom. It could be under reactions. It's probably under reactions. I don't know. It depends on what Zoom version you have. And we also have closed captions available via Rev. So if you want to enable the captions, you should see a button with the letter CC at the bottom of your Zoom screen that has the words live transcript below it. And you can just click on that icon to enable the captions. And if you have any questions or you just want to say hi to everybody and introduce yourself, you can just feel free to use the chat box. We like to see everybody saying hello. So for those of you who are new tonight, here's how it's going to go. We are very excited to have two featured presenters and two groups of short pitches, which will each be 1 minute in length. I'm going to ring a bell at the end of the 1 minute, so hopefully everybody will stay on track. And if you go much over 1 minute, I'm going to have to mute you. So sorry about that in advance, but don't say I didn't warn you. And then after our first featured presenter, I'll call the names of all the people that are going in group A for their short pitches. And Priscilla will drop your names in the chat box as well. So be ready to go when your name is called, and then we'll repeat the process after the second featured presenter. After everybody goes, there's still time left, there usually is. I'll ask if anybody else would like to make a short micro pitch, which is 30 seconds. You can raise your hand, either using the Zoom function or literally raising your hand if I can see you. And we'll call on you and you can give your 30 second pitch. And then afterwards we'll do some breakout sessions so people can follow up with projects or ask questions or just chat with people that you haven't seen in a while. And you can move your breakout room at any time. You have the power. You just click on breakout rooms and you'll see who's listed in each room. You just click on the blue number of the room and you can join that room. You can move yourself around or just message me and I'll move you, whatever you want to do. So more very quick announcements, and then I will do a land acknowledgement. So tonight, first off, I want to thank Priscilla Sun, our Programs and Communications Manager, who makes everything go so smoothly. I mentioned we are recording. It'll be on the Facebook page as well as the YouTube channel. So we love to see your faces. So please keep your camera on if you can. If you don't want to, that's fine. If you want to share anything tonight via social, please use the hashtag, hashtag A4 Town Hall. We love it when you tag us. If you can fill out a post-event survey, that would be so great. We will drop the link in the chat as well. But we're always trying to improve. We want to hear what you need, what you want, what we're doing well, what we're not doing well, so we can do better. We're here for you, seriously. So please fill that out. We're actually in the process of developing a big survey to know more about you and what we're doing right and what we're doing wrong, what we can do better. So we'll be sending that out. We hope that you'll take that survey when it comes out, probably in November. But a few short A4 announcements and some announcements from our friends. Next month, actually a month from tonight, on Thursday, October 24th, we are hosting an online fundraiser to help us to continue to support artists and arts organizations like we do. Actually, we're not hosting it. The comedian Donald Chang is going to be hosting it, and it's called Game Night with two A's, like Asian American Game Night. And it is an evening of interactive games with a creative twist. So artists are going to lead us through really fun games like Paper Cut Pictionary, sponsored by Fiskars, where you're going to have to guess the character being cut out by master paper cut artist Ming Ling Lao. And we're going to have a dance bingo with numbers created by the dancers Annie Heath and Nikki Farahani. And the cards are going to be designed by the illustrator Jeremy Nguyen. And we're going to have impossible charades, where you have to guess ridiculous words that are going to be created with our A4 virtual resident artist, Purin Seed. And we're going to have a name that artist, kind of like the Masked Singer meets Jeopardy meets YouTube. And that's going to be with Leslie Mock, who is our current Van Leer Fellow. So it's going to be a lot of fun. It's from 7 to 8:30. There are going to be some amazing prizes, lots of gift certificates and beauty baskets and food and all sorts of things. So go online, get a ticket. It's special tickets are $150. It's a fundraiser, remember, but we also have pay what you wish tickets. So if anybody wants to come, please do not let money be a barrier. We want to see you there, and you're welcome to watch. You don't have to participate. You can just come and lurk if you want, but we'd love to have you come and join us. We promise it's going to be fun. And then next month, we're going to be presenting Town Hall, and that's going to be focused on the visual arts. And then on Tuesday, the 16th, we're bringing back Table Dish. And this is kind of like a career roundtable slash Ask Me Anything event. We have six very talented, established writers who you can sign up and you can meet with them in small groups of three or four people. And then you rotate and you get to meet with three of them over the course of the evening. It's really great. We've had we've had them for theater. We've had it for visual arts. We've had one for music. We have one for music. And the feedback we get is amazing because you can, like I said, you can ask these people anything. They love sharing their information, knowledge, mentorship. It's if you are interested in being an arts writer, if you're looking for a side hustle from your discipline and want to get involved in writing, want to parlay your expertise in some way. If you're an artist and just want to know how to get better coverage, what are writers look for? This is a good workshop opportunity for you. So we'll be sharing more information and all the names of that very soon. Another opportunity, our friends at the Noguchi Museum are holding an open call for Queens-based artists to design the banners outside of their museum. The deadline is September 24th. So any self-identifying Asian American Pacific Islander artist, 18 and older, living in Queens or with a studio in Queens, you're eligible. Winners get $1,000. And there'll be two runners up, each getting $500. You get lots of great prizes. It's not a game show, but whatever. So full disclosure, a member of A4, you don't know which one of us, is going to be on the jury, as well as someone from Queens Council in the Arts, and then a cross-disciplinary team from the Noguchi Museum. So that's really great. Check that out. And our other friends at Think Chinatown, we have lots of friends, our friends at Think Chinatown are organizing Moon Square after the Mooncakes, which is an exhibition of repurposed mooncake tins. So recycling, as they do, good citizens. So anyway, if you're interested in participating, you can just let them know by October 4th. You have to just send an image of the finished work by October 13th and drop it off in person. So Priscilla dropped the link in the chat. You can learn more about that. And then finally, just a friendly reminder to share your work and your projects with us on our calendar. It's free. It's super easy. There's a community login tab. Depending if you're on your phone, or just scroll down, it says community login, click on that. Or at the top of the menu, there's also community login link, so just click on that. Very, very easy, very fast. So recommend that you do that. Now, as always, we thank our supporters at Capital One and Con Edison and the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs in partnership with the New York City Council, New York State Council on the Arts, with the support of Governor Kathy Hochul and the New York State Legislature, the National Endowment for the Arts, the Howard Gilman Foundation, our friends at Fiskars, the Tiger Foundation, and so many, many generous individuals who make Town Hall possible. And if you want to be one of our supporters, feel free to donate. We always welcome the support. So you can text to donate or you can go online. I'm going to do a brief land acknowledgement because before the Zoom life, we would be meeting in the A4 offices, which are on the unceded lands of the Munsee, Lenape, and the Canarsie peoples. But since we're meeting virtually, and I personally am Zooming in from the lands of the Haudenosaunee and the Seneca peoples, I would like to share a digital land acknowledgement, which was written by Canadian theater artist Adrian Wong, as we're all occupying different physical spaces. Since our activities are shared digitally to the internet, let's also take a moment to consider the legacy of colonization embedded within the technologies, structures, and ways of thinking we use every day. We're using equipment and high-speed internet not available in many Indigenous communities. Even the technologies that are central to much of the art that we make leave significant carbon footprints, contributing to changing climates that disproportionately affect Indigenous peoples worldwide. I invite you to join me in acknowledging all of this, as well as our shared responsibility to make good use of this time, and for each of us to consider our roles in reconciliation, decolonization, and allyship. And so we have two amazing presenters tonight, Chelsea Ainsworth and Jay Miners. And I'm so excited Jay is gonna perform. We don't usually have a performance at Town Hall, but I'm very excited to introduce our first featured presenter, Chelsea Ainsworth. I got to meet Chelsea earlier this year when I went to Arts and Sight to see work in person, in real life, by our 2020 Jidin Wang fellow, Rohan Bhargava. It was so great to experience live dance again after the year that we've had. So Chelsea is the co-artistic director of Dual Rivet, a woman-led contemporary dance company, and she is the co-founder and executive director of Arts on Site, which is a nonprofit organization located here in the East, in the East Village on St. Mark's Place. And it's dedicated to supporting artists of all disciplines by offering affordable studio and performance spaces. Chelsea also built and curates residencies at a retreat and residency center in the Shawangunk Mountains in upstate New York, AOS, R&R, in the Gunks. And she has taught and danced and worked with companies from the Staatstheater Kassel in Germany to Chen Dance Center right here in New York City. So I give you Chelsea.
Well, thank you so much, Lisa. That was really amazing. What a wonderful introduction. Just to introduce myself really quick, my name is Chelsea Ainsworth. I am the executive director of Arts on Site. A little accessibility, I am a white woman with curly brown hair sitting in a bedroom that is pretty much all white with a little window beside me. And I'm currently on Lenape land. And I wanted to just start by saying that this meeting of minds is so wonderful, and I'm so thankful for Lisa and for Priscilla for reaching out. Thank you so much. For those of you who don't know much about Arts on Site, we are a women-led nonprofit organization. Our mission is to support artists and build community, and we've been doing that since 2016 in a building on 12 St. Mark's Place, where we host residencies for artists, we curate performances for artists, and then we also take artists upstate New York and give them space so that they can make work to bring them back to the city. Our mission has shifted since the pandemic started a little bit. We became a women-led organization and have begun to shift our minds towards representing and producing performances that are geared towards highlighting marginalized artists. This past few months, I've been able to close up one of our spaces in the city. We have 5 studios, close one of the spaces up and build a performance space, a new theater. And with that new theater, we've been producing shows every weekend since June. And that came about because throughout the pandemic, we hosted almost 350 shows where all of our audience was masked, all of our performers were masked, we did socially distant seating, and realized that we were really interested in continuing to produce artists in that way. So I actually have a little video that we'll share with you. It's just gonna give you a little insight as to what Arts Insight looks like. You'll get a peek into our studios, you'll get a peek into some of the performances during the pandemic. So here's a little bit about Arts on Site.
Thank you. That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June, I said that's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem.
So that's a little bit about what we've done. We essentially were running as a performance and a residency space pre-pandemic, and then started with outdoor shows. We actually built a stage on our roof on 12 St. Mark's Place and hosted outdoor performances, and then shifted them indoors and did masked performances. And it's at these performances that I actually met Jessica Chin. And she started aligning with our ideas at Arts Insight to begin to curate specific highlighted groups of individuals. And she and I came together in May and decided to curate and host 2 weeks of a festival called We Belong Here. That was an Asian American Pacific Islander festival. And we curated 10 choreographers on 2 separate weekends, all identifying as Asian American. And the last thing that I wanted to share with you is that we are going to continue these festivals for the next 3 years, where we're curating an AAPI festival, we'll be curating a BIPOC festival and an Indigenous festival. And then if you are interested to know more about that, I can share our website that has our ticket link, and you can see all the upcoming shows that we have. But this is the last thing that I have to share with you tonight is actually Jesse Obrimsky's piece. He created a piece that was performed by Connie and Blue. And this piece, what can I say about this piece? This piece is one of my all-time favorites that we presented from the past weekend. And it's about belonging and acknowledging space and land that you feel like you belong to. So this is a piece that's by Jesse Obrimsky. If we could actually start it at about 32 seconds, that would be wonderful. Sorry to ask that. Wow. Right. Yeah. Awesome. So that was a piece by Jesse Obremski. It's titled Invisible. And I thought it would just be wonderful to share. I wish you could all be in the theater with us. But yeah, that's a little bit about Arts Insight and about what we do. And if you're interested to know more, I'll share a link of upcoming performances that we have. Again, our mission is just to support artists, and we're doing that over the next 3 years by building a group of festivals. And one of them is this AAPI festival that I'm co-curating with Jessica Chin. And I will keep you all in the loop and give you more information about that. But if you do want to see music, theater, or dance any weekend for the next 3 years, we're your people. We're a small space. There's 34 seats. And yeah, we're curating dance and theater and music. So that's me. Thank you guys so much for having me.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Chelsea. That's lovely. And I'm sure Jessica and you will be sharing more information about the festival. And if people want to sign up for it or get more information, they can certainly go onto your website, artsonsite.org, correct? And great. And like I said, we'll be sure to share that on the A4 calendar. So thank you for that. So now we're going to move to our first group of 1 minute pitches. So we have Veronica Dang, Anna Mae Southern, Haley Savage, Joseph Freya, Lucy Yao, Georges Bridges, Seto Yamamoto, Melinda Fair, Kevin Toyo, Joyce Yu, Migi Miyajima, and Leslie Mock, last minute edition. So you are on deck. You all have, you will have 1 minute, and you will hear this sound at the end. So I hope you will all, okay, keep to your 1 minute. Great. Okay, let's start. Veronica, are you ready to go?
Sure. Hi, I'm Veronica Dang. Nice to meet everybody. Thank you, A4, for Town Hall. And also I want to thank A4, especially Ting and Lisa, for helping me get the City Artist Corps grant, which is helping me, thank you so much, do my dream reading of Romeo and Juliet. So I've always wanted to do Romeo and Juliet and see an all POC Asian-led cast. And I wanted to make it relatable and modern for young people. So I'm doing this developmental reading to create a 1 hour version of Romeo and Juliet with a focus on mental health, because Asian mental health is something that we don't talk about. And that's in Asian American young adults, suicide is the leading cause of death for them in the US. So that's why I wanna try to have all of you come join in the reading to talk about it and see it and see what works and what doesn't work. It'll be at Madam X, which is New York City's sexiest bar in the Village. So it'll be cool. And there's like drink specials. And one of the drinks is called Love Potion. It's free to the public because it's, of course, the city grant. So hopefully you can make it. And I'm gonna put the Eventbrite link in the chat.
Great. Thank you so much, Veronica. Okay, next up, Anna Mae, you ready?
Hi, yes, I'm ready.
Go ahead.
Hi, everyone. My name is Anna Mae. I'm here to introduce Loop of the Loom to those of you who haven't heard of us. Loop of the Loom is a Japanese saori weaving studio and fiber art studio founded by my boss, Yukako Satone, in 2005. We have daily saori weaving classes and a regular schedule of fiber arts workshops. We also host frequent exhibitions of artists' work on our studio walls. We have two studios, one in on the Upper East Side and one in Dumbo in Brooklyn. Right now we're currently exhibiting the weavings of Japanese fiber artist Nobuko Tsuruta. If you'd like to find out more about our studio, or if you'd like to exhibit your work at our studio and want to get in touch with us, you can visit loopoftheloom.com or email us contact@loopoftheloom. Yeah, and if you have any questions, feel free to message me in the chat. Thank you for having me, April.
Perfect timing. Okay, next up is Haley. Haley, you're with us? I thought I saw you earlier.
Okay, yeah, do you see me now?
I see you. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, I'm Haley Savage. Thanks so much for having me. I am the co-founder and events producer at Keepsake House. Jay Miners, who'll be performing here soon, is our fellow co-founder. And Keepsake House is a brand new listening room for independent artists in New York City and beyond. We host intimate concerts featuring live music, both virtually and in person around the city. We're known for our roundtable shows, which feature multiple musicians on stage together and interweave conversation throughout the performance. We have a couple shows coming up, starting with next Monday, September 27th, our first solo show featuring Korean-American singer-songwriter Sarah Kang. You'll see the poster in a second. And we're also open to artist submissions. We're always on the lookout for live performers, and we're committed to working with majority BIPOC artists, and especially, as you can see from a lot of our media, Asian-American artists. So you can find out more about us and submit your music at keepsakehouse.com. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Haley. That's great. All right. Next up, Joseph Freya.
Yes. Hello, everyone, and thank you for having me tonight. I'm here to talk about two projects that I have. One is the book that you see also there, Life is a Treasure Hunt, which is based on my studies on Western psychology and Eastern medicine and the spiritualism. Of course, it's based mostly on the study on chakras and the Tao Te Ching. Me, myself, I'm an expert in reading the I Ching. So hopefully it's a self-development, self-growth book that, of course, like I hope can help people. You have the contact here and I will drop on the chat. And the other one is, I'm also an art curator. I'm the chairman of the PR committee at Salma Gandhi Club, and I'm organizing an art project that it's called We Are Not That Far, which is supposed to say everything in the title, bringing together Eastern and Western culture and art. So I will drop my contacts. And of course, if anybody wants more information, please reach out to me. And if you want to check out the book, please check the website. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much. All right. Next up is Lucy. Lucy Yao from McDuo. Lucy.
Hey. There you are.
Hello. Okay.
Hi, I'm here. Hi, so I'm going to be sharing with you stories for Chinatown, from Chinatown. It's an augmented reality project. There we go. Yes. That partners with Welcome to Chinatown and Mott Street Girls to share the stories of local businesses. And what we're doing is, nice pictures. Okay. So we are featuring local businesses and are looking for calls for sound artists and composers to submit pieces that would fit with the murals in Chinatown. So there's the 88 Gates project. There's one that's, you know, featuring the Zodiac. You can just scroll down there if you, there we go. Cool. And of course, it's like the Stop AAPI Hate. And we're having our kickoff on October 30th as an opening ceremony. So basically it's something that you can experience on your phone, and there's already sound walks that you can go on your phone and, you know, do existing routes, and it's all over the US. So we're hoping to create a platform for the AAPI composers to share their stories. So I'll drop the links. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you so much, Lucy. All right, next, Georges from the Film Lab.
Hi, everyone. My name is Georges Bridges, and I'm from the Asian American Film Lab. I'm the community outreach liaison. I'm here to talk about unfinished works. Well, first of all, we promote ethnic and gender diversity in the film industry. And I'm here to talk about one of our oldest programs, which is unfinished works. And if you're a screenwriter or a writer and you have a work and you'd like to get some type of feedback on your work, if you're selected, then we could possibly provide a space for you so you can get a critique on your work. Three of our upcoming events are in September, October, and November, the first being tomorrow. I posted the link to the Eventbrite in the chat. Our website is AsianAmericanFilmLab.com. And the first workshop, as I mentioned, is tomorrow. It's by Kevin Tran, and it's Vietnamese ghost story, and it's very good. And I'm actually doing the reading part and part of the reading, which is pre-recorded. We hope you can join us for that or provide any submissions if you're interested. Thank you very much.
Perfect timing, Georgia. You've got this down. All right. Next, Seto Yamamoto. Seto, you with us?
Thank you very much. Yes. Hi, my name is Sato Yamamoto. I'm a visual artist in New York, and very appreciate to have a City Artist Corps grant as an individual this summer. And I actually analyzed myself the what kind of categories of fitting for. And actually, my cultural respect art is matching with a library showcase. So I'd like to encourage future artists to analyze and critique yourself. What kind of opportunity is matching for your art? So, and I'd like to keep going my way. So I'm going to drop my handle name as Instagram later on chat. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Sato. Okay, next up is Melinda Fehler. Melinda, are you with us?
Hi, I'm with you. How are you doing? Okay. Thanks for having me. The last time I was at one of these was about 10 years ago, so it's really nice to be back again. So I am the former artistic director of the Arte Venue and Gallery, which was in Greenpoint, Brooklyn, sadly closed in June of last year. I'm looking for help with anyone who would like, from anyone who would like to help in presenting a series that I'm trying to put together, featuring some of the displaced programming from the venues last year and also new projects that have come about. It's not exclusively Asian in influence, but heavily so. So there's one concert, which is Kulintang, Exploring Kulintang, featuring Susie Ibarra and Levi Lorenzo, percussionists, and also Sugar Vendel and myself, Filipino-American musicians who are working with experimental, treating Kulintang in an experimental fashion in new ways. There is another concert, which is by Iranian pianist Nush Muadzeni, who will be coming to Canada. Oh, I need help. I will be dropping. I'll be dropping my email in the chat if anybody would like to help organize this series with me.
Great. Thank you, Melinda. Please do share that information. We've got some incredible organizers here with us. Next is Kevin Toyo. Kevin, are you with us?
Yes.
Great. Okay, go so, right ahead.
Okay, sorry. This is the first time I'm doing this, so this is probably going to be terrible. But here we go. My name is Kevin Toyo. I am mainly a Japanese folk dancer, but I'm also an individual artist as well. And I received a City Artist Corps grant to put on a performance this Saturday, 7:30 p.m. at Abrams Arts Center, called Not Your Mother's Pan-Asian Festival. This is sort of a fun thing we're doing where it will be performances that are traditional and contemporary as well. So sort of really showing the breadth of AAPI expression. I'll be performing a Japanese folk dance piece as well as a contemporary one. Kelly Tsai, Dancers Unlimited, Gorno, Suzuki Tanabe, and also performances of Indian classical dance as well as dance from Mindanao. So it should be very interesting use of the space as well with lighting, so it should be a great performance. So please come out and support all AAPI performers and choreographers. So please come and enjoy this Saturday, and I'll put information in the chat and follow me Instagram, Kevin Toyo.
Perfect.
Thanks
Kevin, drop it all in the chat. Okay, next we have Joyce Yu from the Asian Women Giving Circle. Yay, Joyce, take it away.
Hi, I'm with the Asian Women Giving Circle, which is a group of about 26 women who collectively raise money for Asian American women in the arts. And we have been around for about 17 years. We've given out about $1 million to over 100 artists. There are return artists. Kate Rigg, I believe, has had maybe two or three grants. A4, my artists associated with A4 have only gotten one grant. Well, there you go. Our grants rate are from anywhere average now $5,000 to $10,000. And Kate Rigg is correcting us, just two grants. Okay. And let's see. Many of the artists who have pitched have been grantees. Our grant cycle starts in end of January 2022, and you see the website, so go track everything on there. And I'll take questions on chat if you want.
Yes, please. And we'll make sure to announce that when the grants are open. So we will we'll share that. Okay, next up is Miggy. Miggy.
Hi, Lisa.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, you're on.
Cool. All right. Hi, everyone. I'm Miggy, jazz composer in New York. And I don't see my face. Is that okay? Are you hearing me? Cool. Okay, yes. I'm going to continue then. Okay, I will have this free show in Manhattan on October 16th, Saturday. This is super rare collaboration between my jazz orchestra with 17 players and the Japanese traditional samurai sword dance. So follow me online for more information and please stop by. So here's a short video of how the collaboration works. So thank you again for A4 for this, and please check out the video now.
Thank you, Miggy. And one more. So before Jay starts, we have a bonus presentation from Leslie Mock. Leslie, are you with us? You've got 1 minute to go.
Awesome. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much for letting me present last minute. Hi, everyone. My name is Leslie. I'm a drummer, a composer, and an improviser, and also this year's Van Leer Fellow. I have many upcoming shows, but my work kind of primarily focuses on transposing, augmenting, and overacting humanness to explore ideas about normalcy, alienness, and privilege. And I will also be joining Lucy for the Metropolis thing. So please come out and experience a live multicultural event with us. And on October 17th, I will be performing as part of a group that was also funded by CityCorps called Bird's Eye with Kaigamist Do Young Kim and also saxophonist David Leon. And then I'll also be performing a kind of live interdisciplinary performance next spring at Roulette. So different things coming up, but I'll drop my link below, and so nice to meet you all.
Great. Thank you, Leslie. Okay, great. That was fun. First round, very fast. Before I introduce Jay, I just want to share with you, so anybody who is a City Artist Corps grantee and is looking for a venue, if you haven't found a venue yet, you can reach out to me, or you can reach out to NYFA. CAC grants at NYFA.org, and that we can help you find a venue if you have a grant and you you thought you had one, it changed, whatever. Just let us know. We're happy to help. Don't miss the deadline. You need to make sure, because you don't want to lose that money. So you need to make sure. It can be a very simple presentation. Just call me, email me. I'm happy to help you. Also, just let you know, DJ McDonald is doing an event called Dance Rising. He's with the dance parade, and that's October 21st and 23rd in each of the 5 boroughs. So there are opportunities for performances there. Frigid New York at the Crane Theater in New York, they are offering 20% off of space and streaming services for City Artist Corps grantees. Imani at the Fourth Arts Block. They have open streets every weekend through October at Fourth Street and Avenue B. So if you want to perform there, I'll drop Imani's email address in the chat. And also MoMath, the Museum of Math, is doing a street festival, a mathematics math festival, and they're looking for performance artists. And that's October 2nd, and that'll be outdoors on 26th Street between 5th and Madison. So there are lots of opportunities for you, lots of venues and places for you to take your work, your performances, to fulfill your obligations. So just wanted to drop that. Like I said, we're here to help. So feel free to reach out if you have any questions. Okay, next up, I'm very excited because we don't usually get presentations. We don't get performances in these town halls lately. So our next featured presenter, Jane Miners, is a singer and songwriter, as well as the co-founder and show director at Keepsake House, which Haley told us is a listening room for independent artists with a particular commitment to promoting Asian American talent and BIPOC and LGBTQ plus artists. And Jay has a new full length album called In Betweens coming out at the end of this year. And I am so happy that she is going to share a couple of songs from it tonight. So I give you Jay. Take it away.
Hi, everyone. Hopefully you can hear me. I'm really excited to be here. Grateful for A4's support for my career as a musician and Keepsake House. I'm gonna play a couple songs. I'm gonna start off with a song called Always Home.
Didn't think it'd go this fast. Goodbye to this house we thought would always last. And this is where Dad's garden grows. Summer hay is my reading place and laying at tiptoes. And I know the memories are with me, even when you move to a town that is new. Guess I tend to hold on too strong, but you're always home, you're always home to me. Stained wooden stairs. Me and Jess will play pretend. Time traveling, company around the table. The seat by the window's where I learn piano. And I'm scared that things change too quickly. Bedtime tales from mom sing loud in my heart. And I know I'm not alone. You're always home. You're always home to me. You're always home. You're always home.
Thank you. I also wanted to share, I know Lisa mentioned I will be releasing a full-length album. It'll be my first. I'm going to turn the reverb off because I feel like this is a little too in the mood. It will be my first full-length record, and it's called In Betweens, and it'll be coming out October 8th, so 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now. And I'll be celebrating with my return to live shows. I haven't played live in a while, and I'm really excited to be playing with a band. So that'll be October 14th, and it'll be put together in partnership with Keepsake House, which, you know, as you heard from Haley, is we put on shows that intersect music and conversation. So it'll be a very intimate show, and I'll be talking, which I don't love, which is an oxymoron kind of, because I have a business that's all about conversation. But yeah, so that's one of the shows that's coming up. That's on October 14th, and I'll link down in the chat where you can buy tickets for that. And I also wanted to share another show that we'll be doing on October 30th. It'll be a really special show. We are pairing songwriters and storytellers together. And the storyteller will be able to share a story with the songwriter, and the songwriter will write a song, an original song, and perform it for the first time at our show. So we're working with some really amazing artists and storytellers. We have Alex Wong, who is coming in from Nashville. He's a really great Asian American songwriter and producer. We have Annie Tan, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with. She's an awesome storyteller and activist. We are working with Wind Meets West, who is also really active in the independent music scene, and he's providing his music direction and a wonderful ensemble to kind of bring it alive. So we're very excited. It'll be October 30th at the Clementi, the Flamboyant Theater at the Clementi. And it's completely free. We were able to kind of make the show happen with the City Artists Corps grant, which A4 helped us get, which is really awesome. And I'll also be performing at that show too. yeah, I think I'm gonna play one more song. This next song is a song called Morning Joe, and it'll be the last single off of the new record, and it'll come out this Thursday. And it's a goodbye song to a career path that wasn't for me. So if anyone really hates their day job, this one's for you.
Got my head around the hustle, baby. In your cage of fame, butterfly, barely floating. Stains on her wing. Got lost in all your glitter and green. New York Street. My hands on a sleeve. Oh, I'm racing, chasing to an empty finish line. Got the same way and day and pain, same charcoal coffee. Holding on a rhythm that'll go on till I'm made. Don't need that morning, don't need that morning Joe again. Dreaming through the swirls in my cup, but this dream, oh, I can't keep up. Oh, it's routine.
putting a face on every same charcoal coffee, holding on a rhythm that'll go on till I'm 80. But I don't need that morning, don't need that morning joke again. And I started to sing to the stars in the sky, thank them for this long and beautiful ride. With the sun coming up, shining down on us, and we started to feel alive. Oh, oh, oh. Got the same way and day and pain, same charcoal coffee, holding on a rhythm that'll go on till I'm 80. But I don't need that morning, don't need that morning joke again. I don't need that morning, don't need that morning joke. Don't need that morning, don't need that morning joke again.
Great. Thank you so much for listening. I'll link stuff down below. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jay. That was beautiful. Big hand. That was great. I love that. It was so lovely. Yeah, we can't wait to see you live in person. And yes, yeah, so can't wait to hear all about that. So thank you. Thank you again. I love this. Okay. Next up is our group of pitchers. So please get ready. Manolo, Kate, Harley, Iren, Nuo, let's see, who else? Sorry. Jindan, Lily, Steven, Micha, Maria, Sian, and Yasuyo. I'm not sure if everybody's here, but I think most of you are here. So Manolo, I'm pretty sure you are here. Are you ready?
Yeah, can you hear me?
I can hear you. You have Great. 1 minute, so
All right.
Go ahead.
All right, my name's Manolo. I am a comedian and animator, and I've been doing a podcast with Joe Firestone for 7 years. And thanks to A4, I got the City Artist Corps grant, and I decided to use it to do a comedy panel show called The Modern Whitney at Caveat Theater. And it features Mike Nguyen from Asian Not Asian, Gara Lanning, and Christy Cello. And it's exciting. And it's great that I'm able to use the money to pay comedians who usually don't get paid. And among, like, you know, photographers and all that, we're trying to do it up, and it's free, of course. Caveat shows are usually like $15, but this is gonna be free, and so I'm excited. Thanks, everyone. I'll drop the info. Oh, also, we might need a videographer. Hit me up. All right, thank you.
Great, thank you, Manolo. Okay, next up, Kate Rigg. I know you're here.
I'm here, I'm here. And how come I can't see myself? I can only see you.
I don't know. You should be able to see you. We can see you.
You can see me. All right, that's good. Hi, everybody. I'm so happy to see everybody. It's just getting better and better and better here. I know I only have a minute. So here's my project. It's called Disorientalism. It's an ongoing series at Joe's Pub at the Public Theater. And I'm going to throw three links at you in the chat in just a second. I'm going to show you A Cure for Kung Flu, Eight Killer Asian Artists Take the Stage, which is the show we did online for Joe's, which is basically exactly what it said. It was a curated show of killer Asian artists. Disorientalism is the same thing. The first one is November 15th. We pretty much filled that roster. But on October 11th, I'm having kind of like an open call at Club Coming, which is in the East Village. That's Monday, October 11th. You can hit me up on Instagram. You can send me an email. And I would love to see people come out and show their talent. You can also just email me and tell me what you do, because this is going to be an ongoing series designed to uplift and feature killer Asian American artists, AAPI artists, in the city. So that's basically it. And the first one is called The New Eurasian Art Scene. The second one's going to be called, Who Killed Hello Kitty? I don't know yet, but that's it. So I'm going to hit you with some links, and I'm also going to hit you with the link for this spreadsheet I started so we can all talk to each other after this meeting, okay? So here it comes. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. All right. Can't wait for that. I'm hitting up Club Coming. I love that. Okay, next up, Harley. Harley Nigrico. Harley, I know you're here. Yeah? Okay, you got a minute.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Hi, everyone. I'm Harley Nigrico. I'm a visual artist, mostly photographer and sculptor. And with my CAC grant, I was able to organize and co-curate a visual art group exhibition called On Terrain and Emblem. It features myself and three other artists. Their names are Jasmine Castasis, Melanie Gonzalez, and Nancy Paredes. And we're a group of four women working in papermaking, photography, printmaking, and sculpture. Our exhibition is working on unearthing fragments of memory, home, immigrant lineage. We work a lot with landscape and archaeology in a lot of our work. We had actually been working on this group show since 2019 together, and it got postponed since the pandemic. So this grant has been a really great way for us to kind of reconvene and re-realize this show. And I'm very excited. Come to Sunset Park for Open Studios, and we will be there.
Thanks, Harley. Okay, yeah, drop the info in the chat. Next up, Irena. Irene?
Yes, hi, Lisa. Hi, everybody. Glad to be here. I just wanted to share about the Heart on Your Sleeve project that I'm a participant in. It is a project of Saint Flashlight, where she asked six women poets to contribute epigrams that go on these coffee cup hot holders, I guess, and they are available at two Joe's Coffee locations on Governor's Island at the LMCC Art Center and at Leggett Terrace. And you know, if you love poetry, if you love collecting poetry, this project is going on until Halloween or until the sleeves run out. And I also want to throw in the chat later, I'm an advisor to the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and we're holding our first block party on October 2nd. And I also got a City Artist Corps grant, but I will share those details later when they're solidified. Thank you so much.
Okay.
I just wanted to say, like, you know, please check out all the other poets. Like, I'll send you the link. Okay.
Thank Great. You. Yeah. Please drop it in the chat so we can follow along. Okay. Is Nuo Zheng here? I didn't see you in the chat. In the participant list. So I think you are not here, and we are gonna skip to. Jindong Tsai, and I think that is Yaki Zhu who's going to be talking for.
Yaki. Yes. Yes. Hi, everyone here. This is Yaki.
Yeah, let's get you. Okay. Yeah, you're ready.
Okay. Hi, everyone. This is Yaki, and I'm here on behalf of the U.S. China Music Institute at Bard College. And the institute is going to host its fourth annual music festival, Asian American Voices, in October. And here's a message from the festival's artistic director, Jindong Tsai.
Good evening. I'm Jindong Tsai, director of U.S. China Music Institute at Bard College Conservatory of Music. I'm so happy here tonight at September Town Hall to celebrate Asian American Artists, organized by Asian American Arts Alliance. I also want to take this opportunity to introduce to you an upcoming event the Bard College and Institute is organizing. The theme of the festival is called Asian American Voices. We want to celebrate Asian American composers in this festival. And we were going to perform orchestral, choral, and opera works by Asian American composers from Japan, China, Korea, South Asia, Turkish, etc. It's going to be a big event to celebrate Asian American music. Please come to join us. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Yachi, can you drop the info? Oh, you did. You dropped it in there. Perfect. Thank you. All right. Next up is Lily. Lily Huang. Lily?
Hi. Hi, everybody. It's so great to be here tonight. This is my first time attending an artist town hall. And to be honest, I can't think of a better way to celebrate Meme Festival. I came to you today with a sort of in post-production public service announcement on the Stop Asian Hate campaign. And as an independent director and writer, this is my attempt to put out a unique voice and really sort of solidify to kind of have the resilience and have the uncompromised attitude when it comes to fight the right fight. And I believe everyone here tonight understands the weight and the trauma that has brought to the Asian American community in the past. In fact, I believe last time when I did the research, there's a horrifying 395% increase in hate charge crimes against the AAPI community just the first quarter of this year. So we are in post, and so any marketing and distribution aid that I can have from any one of you would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. I'll drop my Instagram handle. Please shoot me a DM if you can. Thank you.
Thank you, Lily. Okay, next up is Stephen Chalaya. Stephen, are you with us?
Yes, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes. And go ahead. You have a minute.
Okay, awesome. Hey, Lisa, thank you for hosting this. Hi, everyone. I'm Stephen. I'm a Manhattan-based guitarist, composer, and a music theorist. I'm the innovator of a concept known as the fusation method, which is basically a theoretical system that explores the scales from the Asian continent, from India, China, Japan, and brings it into a system of exploitation to apply to jazz and jazz improvisation and composition. I'm also a CAC recipient. I'll be staging a concert for the fusation method on October 28th at Sour Mouse NYC. I'll drop links and you can follow me on Instagram and on my website for the event. I'm actually staging a book release concert for the new book next year, and I'm looking for collaborators, visual artists. I'm also looking for funding. I'm looking for videographers, primarily from the of Asian descent. I'm a Malaysian myself of Indian origin, so I'm a fused Asian person. So I'm looking for collaborators. I'm looking for all sorts of things, any possibilities. I'd like to link with all of you. I'll drop links in the spreadsheet and on the chat box, and looking forward to meeting some of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Stephen. That is great. Yeah, drop the links. Thank you. Next up is Micha Chung. Micha, you with us?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead, you got a minute.
Hi, my name is Minija. I'm having solo show because of the grant. Title is Unfinished War Virus, September 21st to 30th, and hours Tuesday to Saturday, 11 to 4 p.m. Opening party, so September 25th at 2 to 5 p.m. It's in Royside, Manhattan, 208 East Broadway, day 402. H2O Project is pleased to present Unfinished War Virus, solo exhibition by Micha Chung, 13 paintings of varying gender issues will be on view. Her paintings serve as an instrument of empowerment. She paints non-binary places and people in an abstract and figurative way. By integrating wellness routines into her work, such as Tai Chi, the strength of her heart builds with her body. For example, in their carriage, the carriage is a symbol of a house, and the woman is setting a table. It demonstrates how women are still confined with baggage. The carriage is her cage.
Okay, thanks, Mija. If you want to drop the information about the opening and the exhibition in the chat, and then people can come and see it. That is so great. Maria, are you with us? I didn't see you in the sign-in sheet. I don't think you're with us, Maria. Okay. We are going to move on to Sian.
Hi, everyone. So thank you for having me. I'm a painter. I put together this group exhibition, Souls of New York City Chinatown, Passion, Hope, and Resilience. It is going to be 15 local artists in New York City, painters, photographers, filmmakers, multimedia artists. We're coming together. This exhibition is to highlight people who dedicated and are still dedicating their life to serving others in the community. Late Professor Peter Kwan, late photographer Corky Lee, Judge Doris Lane Cohen, choreographers and dancers H.T. Chan, and so on. And we also celebrate the everyday folks who strive for a better life despite extraordinary challenges. Laundry workers in the first half of the 1900s, garment factory workers of the second half of the century, and so on. So please mark your calendar. The exhibition is going to be from October 2nd through October 23rd at the New York Arts Center at 78 Bowery Chinatown. Okay, thank you. I'll drop my information in the chat.
Thank you. Can't wait to see that. All right. Last but not least, Yasuyo Tanaka. Yasuyo, are you with us? Yasuyo, I know you're here. We can't hear you.
Are you here?
Yes, there you go. Okay, we can hear you now. Go ahead.
This is Yasuyo. Thank you for CAC grants and FO. And I'm presenting Peace and Harmony Workshop. Japanese paper known as Washi means peace and harmony. Learning Japanese techniques, participants dyed Japanese paper with their own patterns and hold paper flowers to create peace ornaments. Kusudama, meaning is medicine ball, was made with the wish for health. Participants' unique origami flowers are collected and connected with thread, and creating kusudama that heal and regenerated our divided world. This workshop gives participants the opportunity to restore connections with others, communities, and ourselves by combining each idea into one unified artwork. I will teach my origami workshop at the West Harlem Block Party and Saturday, October 2nd from 12:30 to 2:30 in front of the Children Art Carnival 62 Hamilton Terrace near 144th Street, and hope to see you there.
Great, thank you so much, Yasuyo. And if you can drop the information in the chat, if not, we'll post it on the A4 calendar. So that was great. We now have time, if anybody would like to give a 30-second pitch, you can raise your hand, either your virtual hand, or you can raise your actual real life appendage. And if I can see you, it's probably better that you use your digital hand, but anybody would like to give a 30-second pitch? Rohan, I know you want to. Okay, so just give us, you got 30 seconds, and then after you pitch, just drop your name and your info in the chat. Go right ahead.
All right, hi everyone. My name is Rohan Pargav, and I am the artistic director of Rovaku Dance Company. I was also A4's Jaden Wong Fellow for 2020. I'm producing an event on Sunday, October 3rd in Greenpoint. It's called Rovaku Dance Party, and it's an evening of live music, contemporary dance, immersive cultural experiences. We have Indian snacks and drinks, And it, in the end, it's a dance DJ dance party for everyone. We have funding comes from Brooklyn Arts Council. We have beatboxing. We have a tabla player, violinist, guitar quattro, and voice duo. So I'll put all the information in the chat and hope some of you can come.
Great. I want to come. Okay. Anybody else want to give a 30-second pitch? Nobody? Kate,
I just want to remind everybody, I'm going to post it one last time. Everyone who's here, I started a spreadsheet where you can share your Instagram handles, your emails, everything else, and your dream. And that way, it's hard to scroll back through the whole chat. You can instantly see who everybody was and what they're doing. And then reach out to each other for collabs. So here it is one last time in the chat. Please do it. And then I will send an email to everybody once again with the link so that you can access it at any time.
Thank you, Kate.
As a community.
Also, just pro tip, if you want to click on the chat box at the bottom, there are three dots, and you can click on those three dots, and it lets you save the chat. So there you go. You can have that too. All right. So if nobody else wants to give a 30-second pitch, we are going to break you out into rooms to collaborate and meet each other and just be nice to each other. So let's see how many people. We have 32 participants. We will set up, we'll do like 5 people in a room. So that's 6. We'll do 6 breakout rooms. And feel free to pop yourself in and out of different rooms. Come introduce yourself. Say hi, and then we'll bring you back here in about 10 minutes. Okay. Thank you all. I guess there's some people that are still in their rooms. I don't know. Yeah, I guess people are having a good time. Okay. I don't know. Can we close all the rooms? We can.
Yeah, you could. I think so.
We got thrown into this room. We got thrown back.
You did? Okay.
Forced out. So.
Yeah, they abducted us back into this room, so...
All right. Well, I guess we're trying to dump everybody back here. Everybody. Hopefully people will come back. And if not, thank you all for sharing your information today, sharing your stories, your projects. We love this. Thank you, Kate, for marshaling all of the info into one massive, powerful spreadsheet. We love spreadsheets.
Everybody who put their name in that spreadsheet, I'm going to email you a link to the spreadsheet so that you can then use it to follow people on social and continue your conversations. If you didn't put your name on the spreadsheet, it's literally your last chance. So I hope you do it. I will pin it one last time for everybody. And I hope you do it because it's really important. Oops, that's a cure for Kung Flu. Sorry, that was the wrong thing. Wrong link. I hope you all do it because honestly, like even just by following each other on social, it's such a small act, but it's such an important act for our community to be connected to each other so we can really like create momentum and uplift each other as artists. So there's a spreadsheet. So I encourage you as an act of solidarity just to follow everybody on Instagram and Facebook, if nothing else.
Beautiful. Couldn't say it better myself. Thank you all. Thank you, Kate. And we look forward to seeing you. In 2 months, if not sooner. So have a great night, everybody. Happy Harvest Moon Festival, Mid-Autumn Festival, Chosak. Enjoy it all. Eat some mooncakes. Have a great night. And we look forward to seeing you again very soon. Take care, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Lisa. You're the best. Forget the rest.
Thank you. Thank you, A4.